A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 13th May, on the front page you have 63.5% turnout in sixth phase. So this is the sixth phase of the Lok Sabha elections which was conducted. You can see in the following seats for in the following states. So the turnout in each of these states is also given. You can see the highest turnout has been 80.35% in West Bengal. So overall, 63.5% turnout was recorded. There were incidents of violence reported from West Bengal and Jharkhand. On page 4, you have state reels under drought as water reserves dry up. So this is regarding Maharashtra. Situation is grim in Marathwada region in Maharashtra. And also in Pune division, around 750 tankers have been deployed because of the dry spell here. So there is drought condition in Maharashtra as such too. Earlier we had discussed this situation in Gujarat where rivers are drying up, and now it's Maharashtra. So here Maharashtra Chief Minister Devendra Fadnavis, he had asked ministers to tour drought affected areas in the state, and now he has directed guardian secretaries to tour these districts and submit report before May 21. Then on page 5 you have Thrissur Puram festivities begin with Raman's entry. So Raman is the name of this elephant. So it has been, it has formally opened the Thrissur Puram festival in Karnataka. So this is Vadakkunathan temple here. So this is the Vilambaram ritual, which is a 36-hour long Puram celebration. Then below you have death of three children unsettled Kolam tribe. So this is regarding this Kolam tribe in Telangana's Adilabad district. It's a particularly vulnerable tribal group, and three children from this community have died because of food poisoning on 8th May. So this is their news in this context. On page 7 you have Prashant Bhushan sends notice to center on BT Brinjal. So this is BT Brinjal, which has come in news. It has been initiated, field trials had been initiated here, but now it is seen that it is grown illegally in India. So senior advocate Prashant Bhushan has sent a legal notice to Union Environment Ministry asking for a freeze on all genetically modified organisms, including their field trials. So this is regarding that. Below you have Tamil Nadu reiterates demand for IGST, that is integrated GST, goods and services tax dues worth 5,453 crore rupees. So the Tamil Nadu government has written to Union Finance Ministry reiterating this demand. So these funds are to be paid to the state. So under integrated GST system, 50% of the collection goes to center and remaining 50% should be allocated to states. So this is the case for central GST. 42% of central GST is devolved to states and union territories. And state GST, of course, remains with states. So here a demand is being made by Tamil Nadu government on this. And here you have Vedanta gets initial clearance for 274 hydrocarbon wells in Tamil Nadu, Puducherry. So Environment Ministry has granted permission to conduct environmental assessment to the Vedanta group. So it has been granted a terms of reference to carry out environment impact assessment EIA for drilling a total of 274 offshore and onshore oil and gas exploration wells in the Bay of Bengal and regions in Tamil Nadu and Puducherry. On the editorial page, the first editorial is substantive equality. So this is regarding the Supreme Court judgment on consequential seniority and reservation in promotion for SCST in Tamil Nadu, in Karnataka. So the Karnataka government has passed this act, which was challenged in the Supreme Court, but the Supreme Court upheld the act. So it rejected the notion that quotas affect efficiency. And next editorial is deal in danger. So this is regarding the Iran nuclear deal, officially called the Joint Comprehensive Plan of Action of 2015. So that editorial says that time is running out for European signatories to the nuclear pact to address Iran's concerns. So USA has opted out of the deal, but the deal also has other nations as signatories, the European nations. So Iran expects them to uphold their side of the deal so that Iran can continue to adhere to the provisions and the restrictions which it has under the deal. But since European Union is not forthcoming. Iran recently declared that it would also not be adhering to the provisions of the nuclear deal. Then the lead article of shells, companies and GDP. So this is regarding the controversy over MCA 21 data. So there has been now news that some entities around more than 35% of the companies which are listed under it are shell companies, fake companies or bogus companies. So they are not active companies. So this has become a controversy. Government defended it, saying that it would not significantly affect the GDP calculation. So this is regarding this whole controversy, which is very important. And this is playing the division card. So this is regarding BJP's electoral fortunes, how it depends on its capacity to polarize the OBC vote. Then on the UPSC page, this is regarding the war on terror in Sri Lanka. So we recently saw the Easter bombings in Sri Lanka in the churches. So the article says that the world needs to be united on the issue of terrorism and resolve contradictions. And this is protecting forest fringes. So how India is urbanizing at a very fast pace and how city forest cooperation needs to be facilitated is detailed out here. On international page, you have anti-Muslim attacks lead to curfew. So it is in Sri Lanka, in Chilav, where war of words on Facebook is followed by violent targeting of mosques and shops here. So now curfew has been imposed here. Then on Business Review page here, you have this coverage on external commercial borrowings in India, how they have been faring over the year. And also this is regarding the lead borrowers and sector-wise split of borrowings and the reason for borrowing for various companies. So you can see the lead borrowers are ArcelorMittal, Reliance Jio, Indian Oil, Reliance Industries, Tata Sons and so on. Then this article is regarding IT sector, how the top firms want a head of the company. Then this is regarding an interview on economic outlook, and this is regarding telecom sector's tariff war. So all these you can skip. Then there's no important news on the last page, except this you can see. This is the Extinction Rebellion Action Group. So members of the Action Group held banners in front of Eiffel Tower in Paris and spilled fake blood, during a demonstration to highlight the state of decline of biodiversity. So this Extinction Rebellion has quite often come in news, so you should know about it. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asha.com. The PDF for this daily current affairs is uploaded there by the end of the day. Thank you.